stuff. Now, it's time for college football.
And yet another exciting week. And my hat's off to all of you monkeys who sit there and tell us we don't know anything about college football, because obviously we don't know shit about shit, and then maybe that should be the name of our show.
And that's the whole reason we started this damn show, because we don't know shit about shit. That's what's good. And George and I are fine with that, so fuck you guys. So anyway, how about if we start...
For me right now, the biggest upset this entire weekend was the U. They appear to be somewhat back, and they beat Florida. Mm-hmm. Now, granted, they got to play at home, so Florida had to travel into the Hurricanes. And
They showed some tenacity, man. I mean, they caused a bunch of turnovers. Obviously, people are going to say Florida's quarterback play and Florida, you know, the turnovers and everything, but a team causes those turnovers.
Can I go into my Tim Tebow theory?
Guys, this is George's Tim Tebow theory, okay? Now, you know, him and I, we go way back, my friends, but I don't always co-sign George's crazy conspiracy
Here's
shit.
Here's where I'm at.
Okay? Remember that.
Just be glad you're sitting down. The Pouncey Brothers. Riley dropping the N-word Cooper.
That's nigger Cooper. Go ahead. Because he got in a fight with the player. And the funniest thing about the whole thing, he got in a fight. Everybody was like, what happened? Was it because of racial things? Was it something about that the Philadelphia Eagle practice? And the guy, one of the people who didn't want to be named, said no. But the black guy, when he was fighting Riley Cooper, called him a nigga. I mean, come on, man.
So, you know, so we got anyway. The Pouncey Brothers. Back mm-hmm. to my Tim Tebow theory. Mm-hmm. We got the Pouncey Brothers. Mm-hmm. Yeah, theory. Mm-hmm. Riley Cooper and Aaron, I'll kill you, Hernandez. Mm-hmm. All played at Florida at the same time.
Yes.
And the common denominator there is Tim Tebow. You guys familiar with Charles Manson? How he convinced all those people to kill for him just by brainwashing them? It's kind of my theory on Tim Tebow.
George thinks that Tebow brainwashed.
I think he's the mastermind. I think he's just like this, just controlling them. He's mind-banging the NFL right now.
I'm going to tell you what, he needs to mind-bang somebody to think they're going to let him play quarterback, because nobody's going to let that Bama play quarterback.
So anyway, that's my theory on Tim Tebow, and that's why they lost, because Tim Tebow is no longer manipulating Florida.
My theory, before we get back to college football, is Tim Tebow, you need to just say, I don't want to play quarterback anymore and be a halfback, because he had an offer. From an NFL
team.
We'll
get to that later, because we're going to talk about the NFL later. So right now we're sticking with college football.
Okay, so the U.
Yeah, the U won. They looked impressive. I think with one more win, if they go 3-0, they'll probably crack the top 25. They might crack the top 25 here, because at the time Florida was ranked.
Yeah.
Miami just starting to look like the old Miami.
And you know what? With that being said, it's just not Miami. It's the whole ACC. It's funny because Maryland's leaving the ACC, and I'm thinking now, they're thinking, oh, shit, should we have left this? Because the ACC now has Miami, who looks like their program's on the way back. Clemson, who looks even better after Georgia won today. Now you got Louisville that's coming over next season, and they're looking great, especially with this Heisman Trophy quarterback. And then you still got the other teams like Florida State.
He meant Heisman Trophy, hopeful quarterback. Just relax.
Yeah, because one of you guys will correct me, so, you know, whatever. But it does. The ACC is looking like it's starting to take a swing for the better. And you like that? That's for the better. So,
fuck am I?
Who knows? You know?
Don't know.
I don't know. Well, don't know what you're talking about. Hit you with the Puerto Rican judo.
So,